the forehead of your robot. If you thought the Rebirth episode was the only Teletubbies creepypasta that I came across was disturbing, well, there's also another one, but with a different kind of scare. It was on our family day at Invero when my mom decided to go to Woolworths to get groceries for the day. While she went to do that, my dad, my brother and I went to a secondhand shop to do some browsing. I was looking through the DVD section. I saw lots of DVDs that weren't exactly my pick, until one of them started to catch my eye. It was a Teletubbies DVD which was on the shelf right next to a Saddle Club DVD. I soon discovered that this Teletubbies DVD was rare, just like the one that I watched a while ago. I took the Teletubbies DVD off the shelf and began to examine it. The title of the DVD was, Teletubbies, Emily and Jester, and Other Stories. I looked at the DVD and said to myself, this could be my second rare DVD find. But before I could go to show my dad, something grabbed my shoulder. I turned around to see what grabbed my shoulder. What I saw was an old white hair and long bearded man standing behind me. He was wearing strange clothes, and he had a leather black jacket covered in chains. Hi. I said to the old man, waving at him slightly. The old man slowly pointed to the DVD as I began to feel even more confused and shocked.
Do not watch that DVD.
The old man said with a hint of terror in his voice.
The DVD is evil. Evil!
Without any explanation, he began to drop on the floor and roll around, while he was holding up his fingers in the shape of a cross.
Be gone! The evil thing you hold in your hand! The devil's claws will tear you apart if you watch it!
He shouted. I was getting more freaked out by this and raced out of the DVD section, taking the DVD with me. Once I was able to reach my dad, I showed him the DVD and tried to explain the crazy old man I came across while I was where I got the DVD, but we didn't have much time. We had to go help out Mom with the groceries. When we got home, my parents had to go out for the moment, and my brother went to his room to play some Skylanders. I decided to go to my room and watch my new DVD, but before I watched it though, I took a look at the episode list on the back cover. The episodes were, Emily and Jester, The Grand Old Duke of York, Swimming with Stephanie, Going to School by Boat, Naughty Sock, and a very strange episode titled, Symbiote. Symbiote? I asked myself. I was puzzled at the start, but I felt like I was about to know the truth of this DVD. I inserted the disc into the DVD player. The DVD began as usual, with the regular warning screen, ABC DVD logo and ABC for Kids logo. As usual, it then took me to the DVD menu. I saw that the DVD menu was much different to the one I seen before. Unlike Tinky Winky standing in front of a blue light show background, this DVD menu featured a picture from the Tubby Bye Bye scene, where all four of the Teletubbies are present. The Teletubbies logo and menu selection were in the middle of the screen. Play all, select an episode, bonus features and subtitles were the selections, all of them in the Teletubbies' respective colors. I looked at the menu, and was very impressed. This one's much better than the last one I saw. I thought to myself. I pressed play all and began watching all five episodes. It seemed okay to me. I started to think about what the old man I met back at Invero had said about the DVD. It's just one of his tricks. I thought to myself. But when it got to the sixth episode, that was when I knew I was wrong. The opening played out as normal, but instead of a clear blue sky, the sky in Teletubbyland was all in night style with a bunch of stars. And when I looked closer, there was some kind of meteor passing through the night sky. It was approaching Teletubbyland as I have noticed. The intro continued in a normal state, despite what was happening in the sky, but when the voice trumpet began to rise, it did not say, "Where have the Teletubbies gone?" Instead it said, "Prometheum X has escaped its planet. It will now search for a new victim." Prometheum X? I asked myself. Like in Spider-Man the Animated Series? Was getting shocked and a little amazed by this, but I continued to watch it, despite the strange things happening. The first half of the episode then began. Dipsy walked into the shot, and stopped when he noticed the camera. He turned to the camera and said,
"Oh!"
One day, in Teletubbyland, Dipsy was looking for his hat.
The narrator said,
"Where's Dipsy's hat?"
Dipsy asked, looking around where he stood. It then cut to a shot of Dipsy's hat between a tree and a strange stone. As I looked at the stone very closely, I began to see a mess of black slime slithering towards the hat all on its own, shocking me entirely. Dipsy then walked into the shot and noticed his hat on the ground.
"There's Dipsy's hat,"
he said as he picked the hat up, not knowing that it still had the black slime on it. Suddenly the windmill began spinning. Dipsy said,
"Uh-oh,"
in his happy tone and ran away, while the black slime still stayed on his hat. The Teletubbies gathered for a TV event, and Po was chosen for it. The TV event showed 2 6-year-old girls, named Jessica and Susan, who were showing the Teletubbies their dad's laboratory, where they began to learn the basics of science, chemicals and experiments. The girls then soon to learn about Promethium X, the same substance that the voice trumpet was talking about. The girl's dad said that Promethium X is a powerful alien substance that who or whatever it touches, becomes something more powerful than a human. I was shocked and confused by what he was talking about. I soon thought that what the old man said was not one of his tricks. After the tour of the laboratory, the girls said goodbye to the Teletubbies, and the TV event ended, but as always, it played for a second time. Soon the second half of the episode began to play. It showed a shot of the house inside where Dipsy was in, making scared noises.
One day, in Teletubby Land, Dipsy was hearing voices.
The narrator said,
"Voices. Voices."
Dipsy said, feeling scared.
"Will you stop that? You are making us look bad."
A deep scary voice from out of nowhere said. I soon start to notice that it was the voice that Dipsy was talking about. I also noticed black slime crawling across Dipsy. I was becoming even more shocked at what was going on.
"Now you will follow me from now on. We must get outside. There is some work to be done,"
the voice said as the slime started to cover all of Dipsy. Dipsy screamed in fear as it happened, but not in a cartoonish way. He was actually screaming realistically, the same way Po did in the Rebirth episode. After the slime covered all over Dipsy, it took control over him and turned him into Venom Dipsy. Venom Dipsy smashed down the house's door and went on to search for the 3 other Teletubbies. His plan was to find blood for some kind of master plan to enslave the world. I was confused and terrified on that kind of plot once I had found out about it. Venom Dipsy soon found Tinky Winky, Lala and Po, who were playing a game together. They stopped when they noticed Venom Dipsy just a couple of feet away from them.
"Ew!"
they said to Venom Dipsy, but he didn't ail back.
"Okay, now let's go get their blood,"
the voice shouted as Venom Dipsy started to run creepily to the 3 Teletubbies and grabbed Tinky Winky by the neck, as he was almost choking to death. Venom Dipsy sliced open Tinky Winky's chest and purple blood started to slide out the latter's chest, killing him instantly. Venom Dipsy lets go of Tinky Winky as he fell to the ground, now as a lifeless corpse. Venom Dipsy collected Tinky Winky's blood and then stared at Lala and Po, who began to scream in fear at what they just saw. Their screams were realistic as well, so ear-piercing that I covered my ears fully so that they won't bleed. Lala and Po then ran away from Venom Dipsy to try and find a place to hide as the latter started to search for them.
"Oh, little puppies! Come out wherever you are!"
Venom Dipsy shouted in anger, still with a creepy smile on his face. The first Teletubbies that Venom Dipsy went to find was Po, who was hiding behind one of the bushes with a scared look on her face. When she tried to reach another one of the bushes, a long black vine-type arm of slime grabbed Po and pulled her to Venom Dipsy. Po screamed in terror as Venom Dipsy began to scratch the latter's chest, making red blood pour out of her, killing her instantly. As she fell to the ground, Venom Dipsy collected her blood and began to search for the last Teletubby, Lala. Lala was hiding in the house where Venom Dipsy tore down the front door in. As she was about to hide behind one of the beds, she was soon spotted by Venom Dipsy, who started to approach her. Lala became very scared as much as I was. She was soon choked and scratched hard by Venom Dipsy. Lala then died as yellow blood poured from her chest and was collected by Venom Dipsy. As Lala then fell dead on the floor, the voice began to laugh evilly as Venom Dipsy raised his fist in the air in victory.
"At last, we have collected the blood we need for our world domination,"
it said with evil enthusiasm. I soon saw the Tubby bye-bye scene after. But after the voice trumpet rose, it said,
"Venom has risen.
All of Teletubbieland is no more. Suddenly, as the end credits began to play, Venom Dipsy destroyed the voice trumpet.
No more of your ugly speaking. This is my territory now.
Venom Dipsy said, as he then began to stare at the camera with evil in his eyes. Once it showed the Raggable and BBC logos after the credits played, but the logos were all dripping with black slime and their colors were all inverted to look like Venom's colors. The ABC DVD logo then appeared, but it was the Creepypasta version, and behind it, I saw what appeared to be Venom's face staring and smiling evilly at me. The ABC for Kids logo then appeared. It was normal as it was, but it was dripping with the black slime, just like the Raggable and BBC logos. It took me back to the DVD menu, and at the same time, my parents came home. I ran to them and told them about the Symbiote episode on the DVD. I showed them the footage, and they believed me. The only footage I can show you are these photos that I managed to capture before my mom burnt the DVD. I'm starting to think that the old man from Invero was right about this DVD, and just like the Rebirth episode, the Symbiote episode would remain in the back of my mind, forever.